up? Time for some more Final Fantasy IX. Trying to burn through this now. Oh. Okay, so here we are back in Alexandria. Last time, bunch of story stuff happened. Kuja attacked. We were gonna fight Kuja, and but he had other plans. Basically, Braun showed up, summoned Bahamut, and was gonna, I guess, kill Kuja, and, you know, just consumed by her greed, she wound up paying the ultimate price, because Kuja did some weird, hypno thing on Bahamut and fucked everyone's mind up, and Bahamut turned on Braun and blew everyone to smithereens. So, Braun's dead, she's been buried, Garnet's gonna be queen in 3 days with the coronation, and we're back in Alexandria as Vivi because Zidane's in a bar getting drunk and being depressed. Because, he can't be with the one he loves. And here's Blank and Marcus scheming. Marcus is like, dude, that's kind of fucked up. Because, you know, during the midst of all this, we're only concerned with Ruby and her theater shit. That's not very nice. Who are you? You look fucking strange. No, Senna, you're fucked. How are you gonna put on a play, and the only people there to watch are your own gang members and Phoebe? Blank thinks he's so smooth. Dr. Nose and Beatrix. So, you know, we met up with them again. General Titties over there. anyway. Cool, I'll take free summoning stones. Those are basically the stones taken from Garnet in the first place. Steiner being oblivious to everything is normal. Obviously didn't get smacked around too much. And Dagger's throwing a fit, wanting to see Zidane, and everyone's telling her how that's not important, you have more important things to do now, you're gonna be the queen. And yet, for some reason, Aiko gets to wander around the castle. I mean, I don't really understand that. Garnet's gonna become queen. The situation smells pretty complicated. I'll just follow my nose. Horn. It reminds me of one of my books. Well, I didn't even really pay attention to that, so that's kind of dark that. Not only, I thought the king and queen didn't even have a daughter, but they did, and she died, and somehow Garnet, or Dagger, the one we know now, showed up in a boat with her mom dead, and she looks exactly like the dead daughter of Garnet that just died, but she had a horn because she's a summoner. That's so weird, and... like, I don't know, oddly convenient, I guess. It's like we've known forever. You're the only one that's just now finding out. That wasn't a tip-off at all that she's summoner. She just dropped a maiden madane sorry. What could this mean? It could fucking mean that maybe it's not a legend. I mean, is it? I don't know, whatever. Excuse me, I forget which way leads out of here. Jesus. Stop laughing, you poop! Baku, drunk as shit, girl suffocating, hanging from a rail. He's like, I don't give a shit, I'm gonna laugh about it. Oh, God. Let's give the letter to the most unreliable motherfucker. Suffocate, I guess. Thought you couldn't breathe. Hey, the bone ain't here! We'll just call my name. I'm drunk as shit. Why are you even here in the first place, Baku?
had enough of your self-righteousness.
Look at that. He already dropped the letter. Like I said. Unreliable as shit. So Steiner's gotten a little bit more tolerable. A little bit more understanding. He's just still hot-headed. This is his personality. Oh, Beatrix. Because all you know is fighting, when in reality, you yearn for something else. And now we have a befuddled Beatrix. Who suddenly found out what the other thing is she wanted. Pluto Knight D! You don't understand how I feel. It's not a phase. We're in love.
There ain't much treasure lying around this world, boy. Besides, a Tantalus always gets what he sets his eyes on. That's our rule number one, remember? No, you don't. You ain't got no right to join us.
Totally putting words in there.
If you can't even capture a canary, you ain't got what it takes to join Tantalus.
For the third time. Gee, I wonder who this could be about.
Wah, I lost it!
I just thought they said, you know, Garnet couldn't see anybody, and here we are gonna go see her. But, I mean, whatever. Go ahead and buy some shit. Flame staff, oak staff. It's kind of meh. That's whatever. Yeah, well, that'll do for now. Oh, you mean the kid with the kitten mittens or whatever? I know where he's at. And here's Freya.
Cue the gangster music. I don't know yet. Tell her I'm the flaming Emerald. I don't think she's gonna really care about your nickname, dude. Jeez, Freya, get the knot out of your tail. Look at this party. It's good to have Freya back finally. You go so long in the game without Steiner or Freya. And like, they're like two of my favorite characters. I mean, all the characters are good, but... So here we are, back at the castle again. Oh, so you didn't suffocate, good. Damn, Steiner. Well, Freya, you see, there's a lot that's happened. The only one he's cordial with is Vivi. Fucking walk in this dress. Looks really cumbersome anyway. Zidane, have you nothing to say? Soliloquy, no. No, of course not. You just won't be able to see me, you know, most of the time. Rivals, Aiko, you say some funny things sometimes.
tried. I couldn't say anything. I had a whole speech ready for her. But it would have all been a lie. How could I lie to her? Good luck, Dagger. I'll be watching you from afar. Come and find me if you need someone to talk to. It's a big fat lie! It's not how I feel at all. It's not how I feel at all. Well, there's only one thing to do. Go back to the bar.
Tactical Stealth. Blake Edition.
Somehow this letter has gotten passed around. God, man, that letter must have grease all over it. Good patrol, man. Dun dun dun.
My nose is bleeding. Stick your thumb up it! Don't ruin it!
Never mind. Guess who's here? Thought he wasn't gonna stay around here. Hey, it's Ted.
The nerdy guy, Dr. Ted.
Ugh, the card game tournament. How I fucking hate this part of the game. Because I don't like 9's card game. That's probably, if there was like one huge aspect of it I hated, it was the card game. Triple Triad and 8 was so much better. I'm sure a million people would disagree with me, but whatever. Fuck, I hate Tetramaster. Is this really the only fast, reliable method to Trino? as a giant insect. Oh god. Hey everybody, look who it is. I think it goes without saying that now that these assholes are here skulking around in the dark streets of Alexandria at night, something is up. Good hiding spot. No one does. Actually, I am. I desperately need your help. In fact, give me all the cards you have. This is a stick-up! I don't even know how many cards I do have. Whoa. Wait, huh? When did I get all these? Garden. Huh, well. I guess this will do. I've won it with just the basic stupid cards you get. However, it's not easy. And hey, look, it's Marco? I don't remember who this guy is. Oh. So this is the guy that brought BB to Alexandria in the first place, in the very, very opening part of the game where you take control of him. But my family's dead. There's like a whole side thing if you make Vivi go home, but I'm not gonna do it since it doesn't matter. Really nothing happens. Like, you can go there as Zidane and you talk to him and he talks about his grandpa and how they live there, and you can get a couple items, but it's really nothing like story-wise that's important. Oh, it's this four-armed asshole. The Flaming Amaranth with wanted posters all over Trino. you know, that guy's still a scumbag because he's planning on doing something dastardly.
Anything for money.
Wow, what is with this megalomaniac kid? Why is this even a thing? Who are these people? Dude, your sister's kinda on the warpath. She might want to keep her in check as she grows up. No, Vivi, don't listen to that girl. She's crazy. Thinking about social hierarchies and how to control the masses as like a little tiny bab. Oh, it's the scent shop. Mithril dagger and gladius. Okay. I'll probably have a chance to do this later, though. I don't think I need to do it here. What is this? Oh. That's another important thing to do while you're in Trino, is to get the dark matter from the auction house and turn in Stalazzo, none of which I've done and I don't plan on doing because I have that file. Or I've already done it. Indeed. Why would you want a behemoth statue? Iko, those aren't real problems. Don't talk to strangers, especially four-armed, creepy adults who approach you with, "Hey, little girl." Like, flag, red flag! Wow. More red flags! The one thing that this creepster could fear showed up. You have food? You have fucking food? Give me your food! Oh, sweet. I forgot you get that. It's totally like a silly ATE, but that's totally worth it to get that, I think. Yeah, because it has mug. Holy damage reduced by 100%. Hell yeah. What to get rid of to get mug? Jelly off again. Of course, last time I said, let's take jelly off, we got petrified immediately. Oh, yeah. Well, I'm going to save first, because there's quite a high probability that I'm going to lose, and I'm going to have to restart this. Because the problem with playing, like, with a limited deck is, I thought there was a Moogle over here. Is that, if you fuck up, then, like, you know, what little good cards you, oh yeah, you have to go in there. What little good cards you have that can't, that you can win with, I don't know what I'm trying to say. Basically, like, because I have shit cards, and, if you go in there, like, you're gonna have to use the absolute best of your shit to win, and if you, and when you lose, they take one. So, they usually take your best card regardless, so it's kind of important to not lose, ever. So, yeah, there's a high probability I'm gonna lose a lot, but that's why I'm saving. That's a one hell of a tournament. Defeat two people, then you're in the finals. Well, that's all you had to say to Zidane. He could have been fucking lying. I don't know why I bought that. Just, he sells cards, but it's nothing that that isn't the base stuff. Alright, here we go. It's really... I don't understand it at all. I don't like this game. Card game, I mean... I just pick the ones with the high numbers and hope for the best, I guess. I mean, I don't know what else to say. Man, I hate going first. That sound effect so loud. That's all I heard. And you can do that to combo, obviously. See, that went good, but it's not always that easy. Especially when you get higher up in the levels. Freya went and bidded all her money away. That's how she relaxes.
Exciting, huh?
I've used like three different voices for Amran already. Here we get a little bit of backstory on Amarant. course I'm interested. Oh. I don't know why they had to split that up, but into two active time events. Who's he?
Zidane. I don't think he remembers, but I'm gonna kill that bastard!
George Norrie's here. George Norrie's. Zidane in with his Sly Eagle references. Wow, you guys suck as guards. I became a wanted man because I walked away from George Norrie after Zidane told them I was the thief, even though I worked for the fuckers. The flashback bowl over there. I questioned saving again after winning the first card battle because it's so easy, but I really don't want to see that again, that time event. Which is cool. I mean, you learn backstory about Amaranth if you, you know, give a shit. And kind of learn how they met. God, Zidane, stop glitching out and just go in there. Oh, you're playing against that kid. Never mind. I went first last time. Good, this is what I wanted. I just realized I really don't have anything facing down. Shit. And then that happens. Oh, come on. That was kind of close. I don't even know what this is. Tiger racket? Oh, it's a weapon. Weapon card. Hallucination. Someone's doing drugs. Oh, it's Quinna. Why does that not shock me? Poor Quinna. Only lot in life is to eat food and doesn't understand there's an economy and you have to buy things to eat it.
Hungry!
Oh man, what a fucked up person Quenna is. Thing, it, whatever. Rumbustious. Dr. Ted's lost in thought. Again, why? Lesson of one of the lessons of this game no one learns is like, don't go off by yourself if you're a Moogle or a child or a Black Mage child. You get like abducted or kidnapped or almost like, you know, followed around by a creepy four-armed guy. Only thing that saved Aiko was the fact that Quenna showed up and, you know, it can run through trains. And jump into oceans and survive Independence Day explosions, and pretty much is the most invulnerable thing on the planet. I mean, compared to Kuja, yeah, he may have magic and a silver dragon, but let's just throw Quenna at him. What's he gonna do? We can't kill it. No one can kill it. Oh, hey, it's the champ.
The champ is here!
This is fucking crazy, Guak.
Silence, Guak! I'm the champion!
No one guaking understands my guaking condition.
This is definitely where you want to bring out the big guns.
Fuck around. I don't know how I feel about this card.
Damn, now I have to go first again. Okay. Let's just...
Close. I almost lost that. Okay, let's see.
Damn it, stop making me go first. Yeah, eat it.
Oh, it's kind of dangerous to do that. Let's just put this here. Motherfucker! Yeah! Alright! That fucking worked out. I'll take it, because I fucking hate doing this. And the rebirth ring is an accessory you get when you win, and it's awesome. Walk, walk. Boating oglop. Well, you hit the nail on the head, Sid. Oh shit. It's only one guy who talks like a motherfucker like that. Enjoyed the nice little time in Trino, because everything's gone to shit again. Assemble the soldiers, the finest soldiers of Alexandria, to fight the legendary Worm King Bahamut, and you get the fucking Knights of Pluto. And no one else. Okay, there's a certain order to this, and it matters who you pick, and I'm gonna try my best, but I don't remember off the top of my head. Okay, wait. Gather information. I think it... Okay, no. Oh, shit. That wasn't them. That was definitely was not them. Oh, it was Blueskin and Cole, I think. Oh, that's fucked. I fucked up. This is all fucked. I wonder if I get to redo it. Okay, that was right. Yeah, that was shitty. I should have looked that up real quick, but... I got one of them right. And Dagger decided to take a nap. I should have equipped Steiner. I don't even know what he has on him. I haven't used him in forever. You're basically thrust into a chain of battles now. It's a good little series to level up Steiner and Beatrix, since they're so far behind. I know it says to get rid of... Take this off while wear that for now. You get this. You can have the bar. Luckily, Beatrix does have some magic, but she overall does not have very much MP. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. Generic mist enemies from the Ifa tree. Kuja's just an asshole. Nice dodge. I could use her Seiken moves, which are pretty strong, but I'm kind of saving them for when there's multiple enemies. See, he got like fucking 3 levels from that. Or 2 each, I should say. Lovebird knights are thrust in a battle. Who will live? So now's a good time to use it. Leave Steiner to finish him off. Damn, they do hit her hard. And him. Luckily, they don't have any, like, mortally crushing moves. They just have that mist, which can put you asleep, and that sucks, but it's not, like, it's not gonna kill you outright. Two roars in as his final words. Roar! Roar! I don't know what's with these things and the light bright face they have. Speaking of mist, oh good, no one fell asleep though, that's the most important thing. Persistent bastards! I wanted him to say, for whatever reason, it's just a flesh wound. I shall protect you! But it's some fucking weak sauce. It's about that letter. Why was it covered in grease? Oh shit. I mean, Spider's just about to wreck house. When he's tranced, he's so much stronger physically. Screw your Fyra. Beatrix, the fuck was that? He just hits so, like, you don't even have to be, like, max level with the best weapon, but if you're, like, kind of up there later in the game, and Steiner trances, he's gonna hit for 9,999 every time. That's, like, that's his trance, like, ability, because he doesn't gain, like, dying, or, he doesn't have Saken, like, Beatrix, or boosted summon. He just fucking hits really hard. I think it's that way. I think maybe this way? Yeah. Castle is actually a transformer. Castle's in disguise. Can't be helped. I designed the ship as an oglop, after all, so I have no guac idea what could happen. Perhaps. But I think we can at least make it to Alexandria. Maybe. Possibly.
Zidane, I'm starting to feel sick. It's probably from the flight. Go inside, get some rest. Try to stay in the middle of the ship, you'll feel less movement.
Go on, Vivi.
Okay, thanks. Blech. Iko? I saw something sparkle.
Poor Sid. He's like, wow, the only thing that braced my face was my mustache.
Maybe it's the Holy Judgment.
Holy Judgment?
The fuck are you, Iko, what the fuck? It's not worth it. There's so much to live for.
Alexander's judgment has come. I would be terrified if I was Zidane. Like, oh my god, she just jumped off. About the only other Adeline that could stand up to Bahamut is Alexander himself. Like that, even Bahamut got dusted.
Thank you.
once again, electric eye in the sky has come to mess everything up.
Side of your mission, I will no longer tolerate your actions. You will not have the slightest idea whom you are to find. I will show you soon enough. You too, Zidane.
Why would he come to Gaia? If it is indeed Garland, he must know my plan. Why has he assumed control of the Invincible? No, he can't be.
Give me a guacking break.
Guac, guac, that's right.
Magic down by one. I don't think I want that on him. You don't even have anything? What the fuck's the matter with you? I guess you can wear that now, Amaran, but don't expect to keep it. Be the alert of the party. Alright, let's do this.
Fucking brat!
Man, you make me sick. I'm out of here. Next time you want to play hero, don't even bother calling me. Later. Later!
Reminded me of Zach saying that from Crisis Core. Anyway, PB's back on the airship.
No, I don't want to go. Fuck that airship. I threw up everywhere.
casually walks out. I don't know, Zidane. Maybe it was a giant fucking bastard. Of time. Tycho's pissed. Just like, fuck, why did I have to save these guys? Again with the, like, little banner rope thing. The most important thing about Alexandria was not Alexander, it was those little rope tassel things they had hanging everywhere. I mean, think about it. Dagger would have never escaped the castle in the beginning if it hadn't been for that, to swing on the airship. And they would have never have been saved from the piece of stone castle falling just now. Shit, it's not over yet.
Microscopic proportions, the process still continues after thousands of years. Eventually, these circulating souls will no longer belong to Gaia. They must never be circulated back. Kucha did well, if only he had lasted longer. I never imagined he would choose to end his remaining days on Gaia. Perhaps this was his fate in the set in ages past. I too cannot escape my fate. Someday I must face your counterpart.
And here we are back in Lindblom. So that cutscene was kind of important, obviously, from the huge impact and destruction Alexandria just went through now. But it introduced Garland. You know, Kucha's been talking about his nemesis and the guy he must really face. And, you know, what was the eye in the sky? It was none other than the airship Invincible. And Garland is the guy he was talking about. So another antagonist just showed up. Walk. Very carefully. We'll be right back. I'm glad Limblim got rebuilt. I don't like Falsaru. Me either. Oh. That's not the right block. So I'm always happy to return to Limblim. By the way, where's Dagger? Man, isn't there anything on his mind besides girls? Captain, we found this weird mutant thing on the shore. It's dead. My days as a sea dog never prepared me for this! Ah! Okay, whatever. It's definitely not that way. Remember when riding this lift was like, you have to like go in disguise and do all that shit? Now you can just ride it whenever. Unless it's, you know, storming. Then it's probably not the best place to be on duty. Well, look who's here. Man, we went through some crazy stuff, huh? I honestly didn't think I was gonna make it this time. But as you can see, I'm all right now. Dagger, is something wrong? Okay, you're so happy to see me, you don't know what to say. I didn't know you loved me so much. Did I do something wrong? Alright, what did I do wrong? She's just tired. A lot has happened since Bronn's death. I better cheer her up. Hey, remember that promise we made before the festival? You still owe me a date. Come on, let's go. I think she's starting to get annoyed. Maybe I should leave her alone. I guess you have a lot on your mind right now. Sorry to bother you. I'll see you later. My bad. So you don't have to worry about that too much, Blank. What What, are you following me or something? Yeah, what? Shut up, none of your damn business. I guess you have to talk to them first, jeez. Guak. At last the hero is awakened. What's up, Stash? Go Gadget Throne Chair. Like, wait, Throne Chair? I guess it would just be a throne, huh? I understand why she's blaming herself, but at the same time, like, you have to realize there are, like, otherworldly powers at work here. I mean, did you not see the fucking ship in the sky that just independent state Alexandria and Alexander? I mean, they totally pulled a Clara on it. Basically systematically took out every nation. Whereas Bronn was blinded by greed, he was blinded by power. Or he is blinded by power. And arrogance. Jesus Christ, he's an arrogant prick. Ugh. And the clown fuckers are working for him again, too. So basically, your wife got mad at you and used magic to turn you into an oglop. Sad story, isn't it? My lecherous character has led to my undoing. But you kept your sweet stash. Walk. Dr. Ted. The man of many talents, but of one giant nose. Everyone's just yelling. So that's why Dagger wasn't saying anything earlier. Todd, just breathe through your nose, man. What do you think the fuck matters, Steiner? She can't talk. Steiner is also in shambles. So she's so grief-stricken she can't talk, which is weird to me, but I get it. A lot of bad things have happened to her and Alexandria, if that wasn't inherently obvious. So, Guac, is there any hope for me? Usual potion, beautiful potion, and strange potion. Counting on you, Guac. Speaking of Senna, me too, I hate heights. What? Just give me the damn hammer in your hand. It's the special Senna hammer, only he can use it. If I was Marcus, I'd be pissed. Like, what the fuck are you thinking? So in a move of desperation, we're looking for ancient potions to turn Sid from an oglop back to normal. And where the hell did Iko, Steiner, and Garnet just go? Like, I was just here and now they're gone. I think this is a good stopping point for today, but we're on a good pace now. I'm on a lot better pace than I was, so I'll keep, as long as I keep it up, then we should get through this fairly fast. So until next time.